శుక్లాంబరధరం విష్ణుం శశివర్ణం చతుర్భుజం ప్రసన్నవదనం ధ్యాయేత్ సర్వవిఘ్నోపశాంతయే. రామాయ రామభద్రాయ రామచంద్రాయ వేధసే రఘునాథాయ నాథాయ సీతాయ పతయే నమః. డియర్ ఫ్రెండ్స్, వీఆర్ సీయింగ్ వాల్మీకి రామాయణ. వీఆర్ ఇన్ దిస్ అయోధ్య కాండ. వీఆర్ సీయింగ్ ది ఎపిసోడ్ ఇన్ విచ్ భరత ఈజ్ నౌ trying to meet Rama and trying to bring him back. So on the way he has come to the banks of Ganges, and we can recall that he has been traveling with a huge army, and along with him Shatrughna is there. All the three queens are there. Dasharatha's three queens are there, and sages like Vasishta and all of the people are there, and all the public representatives, all the Ganadhyakshaha, all those people, they were also there, various sages and all the community leaders and all those people, all the people are following. It was like a huge, a mighty army. It was just moving like an ocean. That was the description. And we saw how Guha got rather apprehensive about Bharata's intention, and he asked him also. He made all preparations to attack if necessary. So this is again we see Guha, he is stretching the hand of friendship at one, and at the same time he is keeping the force ready in case there is any need for resistance. He has to give resistance. So Guha tested him like that, and he straight away asked, I am apprehensive about the army. And then Bharata feels rather insulted, and he again feels very depressed that everyone is suspecting him. And Bharata, we have seen that he is in a rather uncomfortable position, or rather unenviable position. Though he is a good chap, he is being suspected by everybody. So Bharata again he expresses his desire, and Bharata also, this Guha also, he realizes how dharma prekshasya tadrushah, dharma prekshah. Valmiki used a great word called dharma preksha. His eyes of dharma, he is looking through the eyes of dharma. Bharata is looking through the eyes of dharma, means always like wearing some red glasses or green glasses, as we call it metaphorically. Bharata is looking through the eyes of dharma, that is, he doesn't deviate from dharma at any time. So we came to that point, and in the next sarga, that is 86th sarga, we are continuing the discussion between Guha and Lakshmana. It is still continuing, and you see Guha, he is talking about the virtues of Lakshmana. How we have seen how Lakshmana, he was keeping a guard over Rama and Sita when they were sleeping. Guha actually persuaded him, oh my dear friend, we are all here, we are used to tough life in the forest, and you are not used to tough life, why don't you sleep, I have prepared a bed for you, etc. But Lakshmana declined. At the same time, he did not want to show distrust about Guha. So he engaged him in a very, very friendly conversation. So Bharata, Guha is relating all that thing to Guha. So at times, we have to see what is the significance of this repetition. Sometimes it may look like a repetition, but Valmiki has a particular intention in mind. Valmiki in this passage, he is trying to convey to, he is making Guha to convey to Bharata about the strength of Rama. You see, you may be having some sort of intention against Rama, but Rama is invincible. So that sort of message he is conveying through Bharata by repeating the conversation between Lakshmana and himself. So here you see, he is now talking about Guha, Lakshmana. Guha is now narrating how they spent that night, talking about Rama, and then talking about the exploits, all the great deeds of Rama, and talking about what will be the situation in Ayodhya and all that. So he is saying that on that night, though I wanted him to sleep, he did not sleep. He was just holding guard with his bow and arrow. And he also said, you see, how can I sleep when Rama along with Sita, he is sleeping on the ground. And of course, then he is telling about the valor of Rama. Even the gods, yona devasurai sarvaihi shakya prasahitum yudhi. So even if all the gods and asuras, if all the people, they try to come and attack Rama, they will not be able to defeat Rama. He is so valorous. So that is what he said. So such a person, such a great person, he is sleeping on the ground. How can I sleep? So somewhat like that he said. And the entire conversation which took place on that night, all the exploits of Rama, all the glorious deeds of Rama, he tells. And he also says, Siddhartha Pitaram Vruttam Tasmin Kale Shupasthite. And it seems, and we saw how Lakshmana said, now that we have both come out, I am sure that Dasharatha is going to die. And when Dasharatha dies, my brothers Bharata and Shatrughna will be there. They are the lucky people because they are at least doing the funeral ceremony for my father. We are even deprived of that. So that is what he conveyed. So by saying this, Guha is conveying to Lakshmana, Guha is conveying to Bharata that Lakshmana is a chap who loves you, who regards you. In fact, he said, you are the lucky people. You are actually fortunate that you are doing all the funeral ceremony for your father. So that is why he is conveying. At the same time, he is conveying the strength and invincible nature of Rama. He is also conveying that Lakshmana is holding you. He is having so much of love to you. So they went on talking like that. And finally, he says, yes, after that, these two people, they moved out like two mighty elephants. So that is what he said, Mahabalavu Kunjara Yutha Popamau. Kunjara Yutha, earlier he was comparing them to two mighty lions, say walking on the slopes of mountains. But here he is comparing to Kunjara Yutha, that is two mighty elephants. So anyway, so two strong people, they are there, they are invincible. So that is the overall message. So now, in the next sarga also, there is some more discussion between Bharata and Guha. Bharata again, after listening to all this, Bharata again starts thinking about, he is in a rather contemplative mood. He wants to know what exactly Rama talked, where exactly did he sleep, all those things. He was putting questions, you see. So he, first of all, he, after listening to all the travails, all the problems which Rama was facing, so he just swooned. Meanwhile, Dasharatha comes and Shatrughna comes and Shatrughna wakes him up, and Kausalya also comes and then Kausalya consoles him. So all that thing we see, I am skipping all those things. Then Bharata further questions Guha, you see. Bratame kwa avasad ratrav. Oh my brother, you see, how did he sleep? How exactly did he sleep on that night? Where exactly did he sleep? So Guha comes to, he goes on to narrate all the details, you see, all the details about what he ate and how he slept and what not. Guha, if we recall, he had brought lot many fruits and lot of food stuff. But Rama said, no, I am not going to eat on that day. I am not going to eat today. I will do Upavasa, because that Prayaga Kshetra is supposed to be, at that particular Shrungeberapura, very close to Prayaga, it is supposed to be a Punya Kshetra. He wanted to do Upavasa on that day. So he merely took water. But here Guha also adds one more small thing. So he says, I took fruits and then all such food material. But Rama, nahi tat pratyagrunhat sat Kshatra Dharma Manusmaran. So he did not accept it, because it is not Kshatriya's dharma to accept it, accept from others. Kshatriya is somebody who is supposed to give to others. He is not supposed to do any parigraha. There is a technical term called parigraha. Parigraha means, usually parigraha, Brahmana is entitled for parigraha according to our Siddhanta. That is the reason why we find various Veda Pandits are all these, say, scholars, all these Veda Pandits and Purohits, for example, they will be expecting some money from others. That is because probably it has gone into the genes also. That is because according to our Shastras, Brahmana is not supposed to acquire wealth. He is supposed to live by whatever dhanam, whatever donation is given by others. So this chap, he is supposed to concentrate his entire time on studies. Concentrate entire study time on Swadhyaya and Pravachana, study and teach. He is only accepting from, he survives by accepting whatever comes from others. So that sort of thing, that parigraha, only Brahmana was entitled. A Kshatriya was not supposed to do this sort of parigraha. A Vaishya is supposed to generate wealth, he is not supposed to do parigraha. So here Kshatriya, as a Kshatriya, he was not supposed to take what I gave. So he said, Nahi asmavih pratigrahyam sakhe deyam tu sarvada. Guha is saying that Rama said like this, but we have seen Rama did not say that. But anyway, Guha has added a point. Rama simply said, I am going to fast tonight. He simply said that, but Guha is adding one more line saying that, okay, in fact, as a Kshatriya, I am supposed to give to you, I am not supposed to take, etc. And he also says, Rama performed his Sandhya Vandanam, Vagyataha means observing Maunam, Te Trayaha, Sandhyam Samupasanta Samhitaha, all the three, that is Rama, Lakshmana and Sita, all the three, they were observing Mauna, and all the three, they also did Sandhyopasana. So, that is what he says. And Lakshmana meanwhile collected some grass and he prepared some bed there, and Lakshmana was having very alert, standing with his bow and arrows and with all the angulitrana, talangulitra, that is in olden days, not only olden days, even now if you see archers, you see, they wear this finger guards, because the fingers for the archers who release arrows, the arrow will be moving. So, the fingers, they get rather, in fact, they get hurt, and some sort of callosities are formed. You see, if always there is some sort of rubbing on the skin, some sort of callosity is formed. So, to avoid that callosity, they wear finger guards, and also they also wear guards here on this arm, so that when this jia or this string, bowstring, sometimes it hits the this particular portion. So, this also again he gets hurt, or it develops callosities. So, in order to avoid that, they wear some sort of coverages. So, that is called tranam. So, that is the protection for this arms and forearm and also for the fingers. So, he was wearing all that, he was in battle readiness, let us say. So, he was like that, and I too stood guard along with Lakshmana. So, that is how he describes all the, what all happened on that night. So, now in the next section again, Bharata wants to see what exactly was there, where exactly did he sleep. So, he wants to see the grass bed, you see. So, he says, Sharvara Shaita Bhumav Idamasya Vimarditam. Rama, Lakshmana, Bharata goes and sees that where Rama slept, that grass was still there. And because Rama was lying on that, basically a big personality, a very heavy person, that grass was so pressed on the ground. So, here you see Rama slept here, and then grass looks pressed totally on the ground. And he says, okay, this is, Rama who was used to sleep in the palace with all very nice, comforts, you see. Ajina Uttara Samstirne means all the deer skin and all the smooth deer skin and what not, bed made of that, somewhat like a foam bed or somewhat like a leather bed, let us say, leather sofa, somewhat like that. So, Rama is used to such comforts, and on that some fine clothes are spread. What you see, that Rama spread, he stayed here, and with all attendants all around, he was like that. And every morning, all these royal birds, they used to wake him up, and then they used to sing his praises. So, a person who was used to such comforts, he was lying on the ground like this. And it is something which is unbelievable, he says. Ashraddheyam idam loke na satyam pratibhati me. You see, ashraddheyam. Shraddheyam is something which is believable. Ashraddheya, something which is unbelievable. I am not able to believe that Rama has now gone to forest and I am in this position. I am just not able to believe. It doesn't appear to be true at all. Muhyate khalu me bhavaha, swapnoyamiti me mati me matihi. I feel it is as though I am dreaming actually. I don't think it is reality. It looks like a dream, you see. And he says, time, you see, kala is a time. Time seems to be all powerful. So, it can make and mar fortunes of people. It can make kings paupers and paupers kings. So, time is something which seems to be Nanunam daivatam kinchit kalena balavattaram. There is nothing which is beyond, stronger than this kala or time, he says. And he also says, then again he talks about that bed, you see Rama, he was lying on that bed, lying on that ground, you see. And Sita also slept by his side. And Sita, when she slept, she was wearing all these silken clothes. So, some silk threads were stuck where Sita was, say, lying. So, he also sees that. So, Sakta, Kausheya Tantavaha. Kausheya Tantavaha means this Tantu. Tantu means a small thread. All these threads from the silken cloths, they are all stuck here. And then he says, Dhanyakhalu Mahabhago Lakshmana Shubhalakshanaha. This Lakshmana, you see. Lakshmana is so fortunate. Dhanya is so fortunate. He is blessed. So he is following, and at this critical time he is serving my brother Rama. And even and he says he is now talking about Ayodhya. You see, he has now come out of Ayodhya. Nacha prarthayate kashchan manasapi vasundharam. Even when Rama is away from the land, even when Rama is away from Ayodhya, now nobody will ever think of say doing any harm to Ayodhya. Nobody will think of any harm. Nobody will think of even dreaming. Nobody will even dream of coming and taking possession of Ayodhya, because vane nivasatastasya bahuvirya virakshitam. He may be staying in the jungle, but then his valor is so famous that people are scared. People will not dare to think about it. And he also says, right now the city is not guarded at all, because all the entire army has come out. All the city guards also have come out. All the Sena Nayakas, all the army chiefs, they have also come out. In spite of all that, army also is not ready. In spite of all that, there is no fear at all. So that is what he says. And Shatravo Nabhimanyante Bhakshyan Vishakrutaniva. So, even the enemies, all the enemies, they will not even just touch, just like you don't touch food which is mixed with poison. Food, if you mix food mixed with poison, naturally we all avoid. So, similarly, Ayodhya, they will just not try to do. So, that is what we call the fear of law. In fact, the fear of law is very, very important. More than the real, real enforcement, the fear of law is very important. Sometimes we find it absent in our country. Because there are so many people who want to distort law, there are so many people who want to bulldoze and then threaten the law enforcement people. So that is the reason why we say we are like this. We often admire, okay, oh, in America the law enforcement is so great, and if you see a policeman, everybody obeys a policeman. That is because law is so strict and then everybody is so judicious. But here law can be, say, you see, it can be manipulated. And a very powerful man comes and manipulates, say, everybody tries to manipulate. So, that is our problem anyway. So, the fear of law is very important for any society. So, that is what we see here. And Bharata says, Adya Prakruti, Bhumautu Shayishya Aham Truneshuva, right from now, I will sleep on the ground or on the grass, like what, say, Rama did. And say, he says, finally, he says, with a bent head, I will go and request Rama, and if he does not oblige me, I too will stay in the jungle. So, that is how this say chapter has come to an end. That is a very, very small sargas with some small significance. Each is adding to the storyline in a particular way. So, here he says like that, and in the next shloka, in the next sarga, that is 89th sarga, we see Bharata crossing the river Ganges. So, till now he has not crossed the river Ganges. He is crossing the river Ganges now. Because Guha is now convinced. Till now, Guha was not very much convinced. So, now Guha is also convinced. So, he had already prepared some 500 boats with armed men wearing all these armors and what not. So, now in this sarga, we see how Guha cooperates that, say, these people, they cross the, say, river. So, that is what we see. So, and also they reach the ashrama of Bharadwaja. So, Vishya Ratrim Tu Tatreva Ganga Kulecha Raghavaha. On that night, you see, in this 89th sarga, we see that on the earlier night, he just slept there on that Ganga Kula with all this Guha and all other people, which means that Guha was maybe Bharata also slept. Bharata was not, Bharata and Shatrughna, nobody was keeping guard on each other. And probably Guha also slept, we do not know. Some people might have kept guard. Say, Bharadwaja, say, the next morning, they got up and he wakes up Shatrughna, you see, Shatrughno Tishta Kimsheshe, he wakes up Shatrughna also, and meanwhile Guha arrives And he also asks, he inquires, okay, how was your sleep? How was your night? Did you sleep well? Obviously, Guha was not present there. Guha probably he went home. And how did you sleep, etc., etc. So he says, okay, we slept very happily. Bharata says, we slept very happily. Please prepare the boats. And Guha again communicates to all his friends and then all these people, they prepare about 500 boats as we saw earlier. And some other, in addition to those 500 boats for all this army and whatnot, there are some special boats it seems. Anya Swastika Vigneya, some other boats, some special boats which were called Swastika. So these Swastika boats, Mahaghantadhara, they were having huge gongs, huge bells, etc. So there were such boats were there with large gongs and whatnot. And meanwhile, and those big boats, Bharata and Shatrughna, they got onto the big boats. Similarly, the three queens, Kausalya, Sumitra and Kaikeyi, they also got onto those big boats. And similarly, the Vasishtha and all other sages, they all stepped onto those things. And here again, there is a small interesting shloka. Avasam adipayatam tirtham cha pyavagahatam. When these people were vacating that camp, you see, Valmiki notes, that while they were vacating the camp, they also burnt the camp, it seems. So, it seems this is again a policy probably which is followed by the army. If suppose the army is staying in some place, Rama, we have seen that Rama has not destroyed the place where he slept because he is observing a muni's life. But the army, you see, army where it is camping, probably they do not want to leave any trace of their say stay. So, avasam adipayatam, where we stayed, let us say burn it. So, they burn the tents. Of course, we see even this practice, even in yajnas, when a yajna is performed, if you have seen, after the performance of yajna, say about maybe 10th day or 12th day, whatever is the duration, when the entire yajna is over, that yajna shala is burnt. So, that is again a formality, that yajna shala should not be used again for another yajna. So, like that, probably the army for their own reasons, for maybe for security reasons, etc., they used to burn away the camps. So that is what they did. And all the women, etc., they all got on to the boats. And after they crossed the Ganges, all these boatsmen they returned. And while returning, it seems they also did so many maneuvers, you see. You see women doing, women they perform all types of maneuvers in swimming pools, etc. Swimming also is nowadays an art. So, like that, the boat races and sort of various boat maneuvers, etc. they did, and then it was just a pleasant sight for these people. And Bharata, now he goes to the other side of the Ganges. He reaches the other side, he gives a small pep talk to all the army and makes them ready. And he has to go to Rishi Bharadwaja. So, that is where we stop. We come to an end of this particular sarga. We will continue in the next episode. Harihi Om Tat Sat.